Hello to all of you, my dear students in the ninth grade. How are you today? I hope you are doing well. Again, it's me, your English teacher, Imani Jafari at Ru'al Farooq Academy. In our lesson today, we are going to start with Unit 2. The title of this unit is Music. So, in this unit, you are going to recognize, okay, the type of the text that you are going to read. You are going to know the difference between classical and pop music. You are going to define the meaning of some words, okay? So these are the aims of our lesson today. Are you ready to start? Okay, let's go. Again, the title of this unit is Music, okay? So in this unit, you are going to read an email. So the type of the text that you are going to read is an email. Who is the sender of this email? He is a student whose name is Gustav, okay? So again, the type of the text, it is an email that was sent from Gustav to the festival committee, okay? What do you mean by the festival committee? They are a group of students with their teacher who are responsible about the festival, okay? The subject of this email is the music program, okay? So in this email, he is talking about the music program, okay? So again, here we have a sample of his email. The email was from Gustav Hindman, who is a student, to the festival committee, who are a group of students, okay, who are responsible about the festival program, and the subject of his email, the music program, okay? So let's read a sample of his email here. What did he say in his email? The kind of music that we include in our festival is very important, and it is absolutely essential that we get it right, okay? So he is talking about what? Excellent, about the music program. Okay, and now it's my turn to tell you what is the difference between pop music and classical music. Okay, so as you see in this picture, here we have a sample of pop music. As you see, we have a large number of people, okay? They are excellent, overexcited, they are enthusiastic, okay? And they are jumping up and down, okay? So the fans of pop music are overexcited young people, okay? The second type of music is, here we have a sample of classical music, okay? Here we have a small number of musicians. In the second picture, we have a large number of musicians, okay? So they are performing classical music, okay? So what do you mean about classical music? Classical means quiet music, it stands the test of time, okay? Pop music means popular music, okay? That has a large number of fans, okay? So, after watching these two pictures about classical and pop music, we are going to start with some vocabulary words that you are going to read in this email. The first word is an adverb, which is absolutely, okay? When I say you are absolutely right, it is absolutely essential. What do you mean by absolutely here? Excellent, it means completely. Number two, obviously. Obviously means clearly or evidently. Again, obviously means either clearly or evidently, okay? It's obvious, بمعنى واضح, okay? So obviously, بوضوح. When we say you are going to choose the appropriate time to contact your teacher, what do you mean by appropriate? Appropriate here means excellent, right? The correct, suitable, okay? The suitable time of contacting others. So appropriate here means suitable, right, or correct. When we say classical music is superior to any type of music, okay? To any other type of music. So what do you mean by superior here? Superior means better than, okay? When I say it's essential to revise your exam, what do you mean by essential? Excellent, important. Another word, necessarily, excellent, necessary. What else? When we say essential, it is crucial, necessary, or important. Okay? What do you mean by discerning? Discerning, it is an adjective that means mudrik. Okay? So when you have a discerning taste of a music, this means you are able to distinguish between good and bad music. Okay? So discerning means able to recognize good quality of something, okay? So again, able to recognize good quality of something. When we say John is a discerning judge of good design, so he is able to tell us about what is good, what is bad, okay? What do you mean by genre? Genre means a type of art, okay? So a particular type of art. When we say, what genre does this book fall into? It is comedy or tragedy. So genre here means the type, okay? النوع الأدبي أو النوع الفني. What about the word repertoire? Repertoire means all the musical pieces. Look here, we have drums, we have piano, we have guitar, okay? So all the musical pieces within a particular type of music. مخزون فني. So it is all the musical pieces that we have in a particular type of music. When I say, frankly, you are good. Frankly, you did well. What do you mean by frankly? Frankly means excellent, truthfully, okay? Potentially here is mean possibly, okay? So when we say this change, okay, may possibly or will potentially change our world, okay? So potentially or possibly, it is an adverb that means محتمل. Outstandingly, it means extraordinary, okay? Again, outstandingly, okay, it means excellent, extraordinarily, okay? When we say she was an extraordinarily clever person, look at her, okay? When we want to say she was very, very clever, okay? So instead of very, very clever, we can say outstandingly or extraordinarily. Exceptionally means excellent, especially, okay? Again, exceptionally, especially, okay? What about justifiably? Justifiably means excellent, correctly, okay? So when we say he was justifiably proud of his achievement, okay? So I did something that is very successful, so I was justifiably proud of my achievement, okay? So correctly. Here I have a summary of all the words that I mentioned in this lesson, okay? So your turn to write them in your notebook, the first section. Please write them in your notebook. And I will stop here today. Please prepare the first part of the email to discuss in our next lesson, okay? Thank you very much for listening to me.